It is Sunday morning, July 18th, 2010, looking eastwards along 4th. This is the Elrose Composite School, the Uniflex in the background there, and the Care Center. Looking west down 4th Avenue and around. And north up Main Street towards the rail line that the Canadian Northern Railway laid this far in 1913. And farther east on 4th, you find the old Plateau School that was moved in from in 1970 and served the Elrose School until 1990. It's now the museum. And this is the 1927 brick schoolhouse, now closed. It replaced the 1922 structure that burned in January of 1927. And on Railway Avenue, looking west beyond the modern fire hall, the sign, if we could read it, says Elrose, and this might have been the site of the standard third-class station that the Canadian Northern raised in 1913. Long gone. Elrose was the end of the track until 1915, when the Canadian Northern extended their rails to Eston, farther west. There's the XUGG, United Grain Growers Elevator, built in 1978, now owned by Viterra. Now this is the south side of Railway Avenue. Cell tower in the background, water tower. Classic old false front building in the turn of the century, 19th century that is. And looking west down Railway. And swinging around to the west side of Main Street is the Elrose Town Office. Elrose became a village October 24th, 1913, and was incorporated as a town on February the 1st, 1951. Looking southbound down Main Street towards the Composite High School, the core of which was built in 57, was expanded in 64, and in the centennial year of 1967. Post office was established here in 1913. That's the new one. The east side of Main Street, and a nice little restaurant open for a group of hungry cyclists early in the morning, if you ask them. This park on the corner is the site of the old hotel, which burned down in September 1994. A little further south along the west side of Main Street. And this is the Lil Mills Memorial Garden, on the site of the old hotel. The hills of the Missouri Coteau in the background. When settlers began arriving in this area in 1909, the region was known as La Berge, for Albert La Berge, an early merchant in the region. Looking west down Highway 44 to Eston, Antonia, and eventually Alsace, this is undifferentiated glacial till, some hilly, some flat, as you can see. And of the early settlers who lucked out and drew good land, their descendants are still here.